So Donald Trump held a rally in Commerce, Georgia on Saturday, and it didn't exactly go the way he wanted it to. First and foremost, the photographs, videos of the arena showed that there were a lot of empty seats. Reporters who were present say this is one of the most sparsely attended Trump rallies they've ever seen. And of course, they noted that many things Donald Trump said didn't get the applause that the former president is typically used to. They also pointed out something a little bit more interesting, and that was that the crowd did in fact react to some of the speakers. They were excited about them. They enjoyed what they had to say. And those speakers were, of course, Marjorie Taylor Greene from Georgia and Matt Gaetz, not from Georgia. So a little weird for Matt Gaetz to be there, seeing as how none of the people in that crowd are his voters. It's not even the state where he's running for re-election, but sure, Matt Gaetz makes perfect sense. And Matt Gaetz, ironically, is the one who captured most of the headlines when he suggested his plan, which he has talked about before, to make Donald Trump the Speaker of the House if, of course, Republicans take back the House in this year's midterms. Which, just for the record, just as a little bit of an aside, the recent odds of Republicans taking back the House have actually taken a hit. So Republicans still poised to take it back, but their victory margins may not be as big as they would like to see. So anyway, Matt Gaetz gets all the headlines for that, saying we're going to make Trump the Speaker of the House, then Biden's going to be impeached, Harris is going to be impeached, and then boom, Bob's your uncle, Donald Trump becomes the next president of the United States. Bing, bang, boom, we did it. That's not exactly how things would play out if things were to happen that way, but sure, okay. It's fun to dream, right, Matt? The other person, again, who stole headlines was Marjorie Taylor Greene. She did launch a couple of bigoted attacks against Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg. I'll actually be addressing that by itself in a segment later today. And of course, she also spread baseless conspiracy theories, dabbled in a little bit of Q stuff, and of course, talked about election theft and Joe Biden's incompetence. But again, they received more applause. People were more engaged and excited about those two people than they were about Donald Trump himself. And I think it's a very clear reason why. Donald Trump was just playing the greatest hits, right? Oh, Joe Biden's incompetent. Oh, Joe Biden stole the election, which he didn't. Oh, the Democrats are terrible. Oh, I was great. Climate change is fake. It's not. All of the same things that he has said to these same people hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times over the last 6 years. Nothing new, right? You got to come out with a new jingle, something to keep these people entertained. And Donald Trump just can't do it. He's too hung up on his talking points of the past, which sure, they worked back then, but people are tired of it. They wanted something new. And of course, they got it to a degree with Marjorie Taylor Greene and Matt Gaetz. And not to mention the fact that the candidates Donald Trump has endorsed in the state of Georgia are not doing very well at all. And that's also weighing heavily on their minds. Donald Trump comes into Georgia, into the city Commerce, Georgia, trying to act like a kingmaker. But they look at the polls and they say, well, you're actually doing really bad with the people you chose. So there it is. Trump appears to be losing his touch because, based on that experience in Georgia this past weekend, he's clearly losing his audience. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.